learn English, not everybody able to speak English well, because almost them don't think about the dialect, I think, yes. Because when we learn in Indonesia especially, we don't learn dialect in English. So I think that is my difficulties in my studies.
And how long do you teach here the major?
For about 4 years maybe.
And what grade do you teach?
I teach okay.
In the class,
In all of grades from yes, then I do.
Okay, and have you ever made essays?
Yes.
And how many essays have you made?
I think I prefer make an essay, especially in English teaching method.
And how many essays have you made? How many?
How many?
Four or three essays?
One.
One essay. But it's three
essays.
And sir, in the session, what do I what is the important aspect in teaching and learning of English?
I think the important thing in teaching English is to build vocabulary. Because what? Because I think vocabulary is one of the important thing in language. Overall, in all of language, it needs vocabulary. Without it, it's impossible we can mastering some language or language without vocab. Okay, I think the vocab is the important thing in language overall. So if you want to learn language, you have to learn first vocab.
So the first basic is vocabulary.
Of course.
Okay, and what is the purpose of vocabulary learning for students?
The purpose is to rebuild the student skills, especially in English skill that have for about 4 skills that needs vocabulary as a basic skill. Because like what I said, vocabulary is basic for language. I think vocabulary is one important thing in language.
And what are the difficulties and problems in teaching vocabulary language?
Okay, my problems that happen when in the classroom, usually I meet them when the students don't understand anything in how to say, and they feel lazy maybe to memorize, and then they don't to write down any vocab, and that is maybe the general problems in many students, especially in vocabulary class.
What are the strategies to improve vocabulary of our students?
Especially in vocabulary class, I usually use the method that how the students can change their views, especially in English views that they usually have a view that English is so difficult lesson, but I have to change that. That English is not like their views. English is fun, so we have to make a fun method to make them feel comfort when we study English, especially in vocab. So we have to use some method to deliver vocabulary, especially in vocabulary lesson, maybe we can use some method like games or what's it say? Really memorizing how to pronounce and is one thing that I use as a method in vocabulary teaching, especially in a small group. I usually use small group games to introduce some vocab, especially how they learn some vocab in games, especially for example I use a mysterious word games, like the student to whisper others, whisper others, okay, and one until the others, until the last one have to spell what is the first person say that whispered until the last. That is one of my games, maybe to deliver vocab lessons.
So you ever use the games as your method?
Yes.
On your learning?
Of course, sure.
Okay, it's very interesting.
So yes, you can try it.
And how are the students' progress and responses of the games?
Okay, I think the games is how to get fun. So whatever the games, I think the student always receive fun, and I think game is one of a brilliant method to deliver vocab, especially to ensure that vocab is not difficult. Vocab we learn vocab is so much method to deliver to them. One of them is games. So I think games is one of the brilliant method to deliver vocab lesson.
Okay, so the students
always I get before I starting my class, I always give them a few, especially the material before I have to retell, and they have to remind the material before, and then that is I think how do we make a same fuse in that style. That is, I think that is one of way how to open their mind before we run the teaching and learning process. Yes.
That's great. And do you spend out to help your teaching of vocabulary learning?
Sure, of course. Hand out is one of the student necessity that it is the handout is used to help them to understand some material, especially for example in vocab and other materials, it's need handout. And handout to help them not to much write down. Yeah, not too much. we make happy conditions by them. Okay, so I think learning by grouping is amazing method, because it make a condition of the class a surprise. Especially in my method, maybe I have different method with others. I use teaching vocabulary by memorizing. At least for a day, I have to ask them, ask the student to memorize at least 10 vocab. It means that if they have 30 days, we can get for about 300 vocabularies. And how about 1 year? How about 2 years? And so on. Yes, I think that's method I use to help them understanding English, especially in vocab. Because like what I said, vocab is one of basic competence, basic skills that be able to have children before learning language, especially in English, they have to collect some vocabulary. It help them to understand or to mastering other skills like writing, reading, speaking, listening. That is need. Yes. Memorizing.
Have you ever given reward for your students when they get a good result of learning?
Okay. Well, if it's tell about reward, I prefer give them some stars. Like I prefer say, yes, I give them a star to collect how much stars they get. And after that, we count the stars and give them a prize. Anything prize, I think the prize is not too value, but it is, I think, to them, is very, very great. Yes.
Dictionary?
Yes, dictionary book, or junk food maybe. Afraid or make a mistake, I usually I think in English language we learn four skills, and every skills it have special method. For example, if we have to learn a speaking skill, it's no need to memorize. I think it's need the student have to more drill, more speak, more speak, speak and speak. They have to speak more. Yes. And for writing, maybe. For writing, I think that is need how they have to much write down everything what they know. They have to write down for a little thing. For a little thing. Yes. For example, they have to write down their activity today. The activity is today, and what will they do for tomorrow? For example, I think the assignment is for every skills is different. It depends on the skills.
Okay. And what are the facilities provided by the school to improve vocabulary learning of students?
Okay. Especially in vocabulary learning, usually I use videos for native speakers. I take from YouTube, maybe that is channel in YouTube. For example, MFIT. The MFIT video, I think that is good videos. You can maybe you can try to see in YouTube MFIT English videos. Yes, that is a good videos for native speakers. So by that way, from projector maybe. TV, watching TV in a moving class. We have a moving class. Yes.
With the projector.
Okay, by projector. Yes, we by that projector, we give the students a native speakers videos. Yes.
Very
yes.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much for your
okay.